Hi students, good morning. Myself Shivappa, lecturer in English, Narayan PU College, Kolar. I am going to start the drama Watchman of the Lake. Here, scene 1, dramatic persona, a village headman, Mara, Bhima, other road workers. That story begins, a village at the foot of a hill, road benders at work. Here, this village starts, a village that is by the bottom of the Baba Budangiri hill. Here, first of all, village headman, he was instructing to the road workers to do their work. Why? Because instead of doing their work, road members, they were giggling, talking and doing nonsense instead of doing their work. That village headman instructing and scolding to the villagers. Why? Because they were not doing their work properly. Before the kings arrived at that village, he wanted to construct that road. Once suddenly the king may arise on that village, the king maybe scolds to that village headman. So only village headman instructing to that road workers to do their work. At the time of they were doing that work, they raised two persons, they raised their voices. What are that? Two timid voice. One voice said, "Master, we were doing our work, but means he wanted to say something, but he can't." Then village headman asked, "What means what?" Then that voice once again said, "Sir, we were doing your work, but Mara, that Mara, he was hiding behind the rocks, he peeped into us." Means peeped means we can say in Kannada language, he was hiding behind the rocks. Why? Then the village headman called Mara a lunatic. Lunatic means mad fellow. Here, once that workman called Mara's name, he ran away. Then once again that village headman, where is he now? Which way did he go? Once that Mara ran away, once that calling of his name, then that village headman asking to that workers, where is he now? Then which way did he go? Then workman is saying that once you call his name, he sprang like a buck means of a deer and ran off the hills. Once that village headman called Mara's name, he sprang up like a deer and he ran up to the hills. Then village headman, "Hey, stop all work. Then put down your spades and clovers." Then at the time of doing their work, they took some instruments, spades and clovers. All the construction workers, they were doing on that work. At the time, they took some crowbars and spades. Then, that village headman instructed to that workers to stop your working and throw that crowbars and what they took that instrument, stop our works. You go and bring that Bhima, that is Mara, here. Then, if he resists, bring him at once, go. Then, relation man instructed to that workers. Then, all that workmen, they stopped their work and they throw down their implements and scattered about. They scattered within fractions of second words that relation man said. Then, that workmen, they took Mara. At the time, they heard a crying voice. That voice who is crying there means Mara only. Here village headman enters. Then Mara, "You are worthless dog. song. That once again glacier plants say. That Mara, Mara, you are worthless dog. Means what? Worthless means useless. Then, have I not told you to keep away from here? That village headman already told Mara to keep away from that village. Why? Because that village headman, according to that village headman, that Mara, he was one of the lunatic. Lunatic means mad fellow. Mara. Yes, my master. That village headman, he said, you have you not told you to keep away from here? Then Mara replied, yes, my master. Headman, what do you mean by coming here and disturbing my workman? Here, once village headman told to that Mara to keep away from that village, then once again that Mara enter into that village and disturbing to that workers. Why you are disturbing that workman? Such a way that village headman questioning to Mara. Then Mara, I am not disturbing them. I am here on my own work. Let them go on with their things. That Mara saying to that village headman, I am not disturbing to that workman. I have my own work. So I am here. Such a way he was replying. Then Mara, I am not disturbing you. Then headman, don't talk of your work, fool. For a lunatic. No, don't imagine. Imagine you have no any kind of work. The only work you have now is to disappear. Then village headman saying to that Mara, you don't have any work. Only one work you have, you disappear from here. Don't imagine you have a work. Such a way that village headman saying to that Mara. Then Mara, he was questioning, why so? Once village headman saying to Mara to go away from that village, then once again that Mara asking some cross questions. Here headman once again, don't ask, I have told you the reason 20 times. The king is passing this way and I don't want him to know that our village has such fools as you. Here, that what intention for village headman saying to Mara to keep away from that village means that we, according to that village headman, that Mara, he was lunatic. That village headman, we don't wanted to see Mara in front of the king. If the king may seem to that Mara, he may be having bad opinion about this village. So one day, the village headman, we don't wanted to show such kind of Mara in front of that king. Mara once again, I don't feel I am a fool. He was saying that I don't feel I am a fool. Then once again, village headman, now listen. Keep out of our view the next 2 days when the king passes this way and that. Otherwise, I will have you locked up in the cellar behind the old temple. Once Mara not listening words of that village headman, he was saying that he will keep in that locked that cellar behind the old temple. Then Mara, I will sit here and pray. If that God in the temple think I have work to do, he will take me out. Here that Mara's reply to that village headman, once you are locked in that old temple, I will pray to that God. If that God is there in the temple, I will pray to that God. God knows I have a work to do. Then God will take me out. Such a way that Mara replied to that village headman. Headman, once again, now get out of my presence. You tell us, why do you all stand gossiping at me? Get on with your work. Once that village headman and Mara, between these two, that conversation took place at the time road members, they were not doing their work. So only once again that village headman instructing to that road workers to do your work instead of looking us, you do your work. Then once again Mara, once again the goddesses of the river came to me in the dream and said, the king is coming this way, tell him about the tank. He will listen. Here Mara, he had a dream. In the dream goddesses came to his dream, and what that goddesses said to him means that king will come in this way, you inform to that king, you tell him about the tank, he will listen. And so you have to tell him about the tank, he will listen. Such a way that goddesses told in the dream to Mara. Here village headman, don't tell me that again, you are your dream, feel tempted to kick you. Here that village headman saying that you don't repeat it, the dream, you are your dream. That words maybe tempt me to kick you out of that village. Means don't repeat it. Such a way village headman saying to that Mara. Mara once again, what have I said to offer to so much sir? Are you jealous that the goddesses come to me rather than to you in dream? Shall I repeat the very words she uttered? Here that Mara replied to the village headman, that village headman feeling jealous to that god, to that Mara. Why? Because instead of that goddesses comes to that village headman's dream, that goddesses comes to that Mara's dream. So only village headman feeling jealous about Mara. Such a way Mara's reply to the village headman. Here once again village headman, no, be off and like a good fellow keep to your back here till the king departs. I will give you a fine gift if you behave yourself. Then that village headman saying to Mara, if you are keep away from that this village, or if you are staying in that old temple, I will give you finest gift to you. Such a way that village headman saying to that Mara, then Mara replied to that, another person has already given me the greatest gift. That Mara replied to that village headman, another person already gave the greatest gift to him. Then village headman once again questioning, who is that great man? Then who is that great man who gave that gift to you? Then Mara, he was replying to that village headman, yes, my father-in-law. His father-in-law gave the greatest gift to him. Then once again, that village headman, he became very angry. Why? Because all the workmen's they went on following these two persons' conversation. Two persons means village headman and Mara. Here, stop harming everyone. I will stop you all without work if I got you again laughing at this fellow's mad pattern. Shut up. Come here, Bhima. Throw down your crowbars. I have another piece of work for you. Come here. Then that village headman called to that Bhima. All other workers, they went on laughing. They went on following these two persons' conversation. They went on laughing once they heard the voice of that Mara. Then once again, village headman became angry. And then he was saying to that, order to that workers to do their work. And then he called to Bhima, come here Bhima, I'll give you another piece of work to do. What work means? Then Bhima, yes master, I have come. What is your command? Then Bhima came, yes master, I have come. What is your command? Headman, bind this fellow hand and foot and throw him into the cellar behind the old temple and keep him there Still the day after tomorrow, do you understand? Yes, that Bhima, that village shepherd called Bhima, bind this fellow's hand and foot and keep into that cellar behind the gold temple. Such a way that our village shepherd told that Bhima, Bhima, yes master, he agreed. Then headman, Mara, have a look at this gate, means he having enormous personality. Bhima having enormous personality. Gate means he have enormous personality. He can swing an elephant by his tail. So have a care. If you try any tricks on him, he will crush you between his thumb and forefingers. Means here Vinayashankar saying to that Mara, don't use any tricks escaping from that Mara. Once you are using any tricks escaping from that Mara, he will crush you between thumb and forefinger. Such a way that red man saying to that Mara. Then Mara's reply, how did you manage to grow so fat? Then Mara asking some questions to that Bhima. Why? Because Bhima having enormous personality and physical strength. Then he asking some questions to Bhima. How did you go enormous or fat, so fat? Then Bhima's reply to that, my mother gave me highland equation when I was a baby. When Bhima was a baby, at the time Bhima's mother gave highland equation to him. And at every dawn, I ran off the hills with a large gridstone on my back. Then, how did he manage to grow a fat or enormous personality into that Bhima? For Bhima, once he was a baby, at the time his mother gave iron equation, and every dawn time, then he was carrying a large gridstone to that hillside. It is a very big stone. Means he was carrying a large gridstone in his bag. He was practicing or doing some exercises to maintain his body. Then you cannot move even an inch. Then Bhima saying to that Mara, if any other person when he carries that large gridstone in his bag, even they cannot move an inch. Why? Because Bhima's mother gave iron equation to him when he was a baby. So one day he had such kind of a strength, and every day he will carry a grindle, a large size of stone in his bag, and he was carrying to that bag stone. Then relation back. Here, don't answer his questions. Don't allow him to talk to you. That village shepherd saying to that Bhima, you don't ask to that Mara's questions. Don't allow him to talk. Then Mara, why not? I too would like to grow fat and strong. If taking iron equation, carrying grindstone of hill could make me strong, why should I not try it? Maybe you will not think me mad then. Here that Mara's reply to that Bhima, why should I am not trying to that maintaining body such a Bhima? Or I will take a iron equation and then I will carry a large grindstone up to the hill, and I will maintain such kind of enormous body. Such a way Mara's reply to that Bhima. Then once again Bhima's reply, you can't take the deposition now. Your mother should have put it into you before you were 10 days old. Here that one at the time of drinking that iron deposition, before the 10 days baby. Here once Mara was grown up, then he can't take that iron equation now. So once that Mara saying that I'll take iron equation now and I'll carry that large brimstone up to that hills, I can maintain that body. it is not possible. Why? Because that Mara was grown up. Then that Bhima said that before the 10 days baby, you wanted to take that iron necklace. If you take him now, it is fruitless or helpless to you. Such a way, Bhima's reply to that Mara. Then headman, Bhima, don't you talk to him. Don't you see him? See, he is your prisoner. Then village man, then once again saying to that Bhima, Bhima, you don't talk to him and don't you see he is your prisoner. Bhima once again, yes, yes, I will be careful hereafter. But who will do you? My work here. Then that Bhima, instead of doing his work, he came and he took that Mara to keep in that gold cellar and that gold temple. Then that Bhima asks to that relation man, means who will do my job in that road working. Then once again that village head man answering to that Bhima, don't concern yourself with it. You will get your wages all the same, perhaps a quarter more, if you do this bit of work well. Now take him away and sit over him till the evening of the day after tomorrow. Take him away, drag him like an animal if you resist. Means that Bhima's questions to reply to that patient man, don't concern that work is yourself. I will give you all wages on the same and I will give you a quarter more. Why? Because that if he, that Bhima was doing his work properly, means what work that village headman gave to that Bhima means to keep that Mara into the cellar in the gold temple. Then,
sorry.